अस्सलाम वालेकुम
डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम फरहीन यामिन, वर्किंग एज को टीचर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एजुकेशन, लाहौर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फ्रॉम अ कोर सब्जेक्ट ऑफ बॉटनी, दैट इज़ प्लांट सिस्टमेटिक्स, एनाटॉमी एंड डेवलपमेंट. Course code for the subject is BOTN 1112. The topic which we are going to discuss today is related to structure and development of microsporogenesis. As the title of today's lecture indicates, that it is related to microsporogenesis, means here we will talk about the production of or formation of microspores. And for this, first, so here are the contents. Definitely, if we are going to discuss about the structure and development of microsporogenesis, we will recall the knowledge, or we will recall about stamens or anther structure, because microsporogenesis is related to the male reproductive part of the flower. And for this, we should also have a knowledge that what is a microspore and what is the term microsporogenesis. Next, we will talk about the development of anther, as we have to proceed towards the procedure that explains microsporogenesis. Then we will move towards the types of microsporogenesis, and finally we will talk about a very important layer, that is stipitum. So first, we will talk about the generalized and basic structure of a stamen. And we know that stamens are the male reproductive parts of a flower. And if we talk about its parts, then we know that a typical stamen consists of majorly three parts, and out of these three parts, one is this elongated stalk. By this elongated stalk, stamen attaches to the other portions or other parts of the flower. This elongated stalk is known as filament. At the tip of the filament, there is present a bilobed structure which is known as anther. This bilobed structure is which you can see here, it contains two lobes, and the third portion of the stamen is the connective tissue. Connective tissue is the tissue which joins lobes of anther. Now you can concentrate over this diagram which is showing the two lobes of anther. If we cut the section of the anther, we can observe here these two lobes of anther, and you can see that each lobe of anther contains two pollen sacs. And if here we are talking about two lobes of anther, definitely these two lobes of anther contains total four pollen sacs. Pollen sac is the structure at the region where microspores will develop, and ultimately they will form pollen grains. So this structure is also known as microsporangia. Means in case of a bilobed anther, this whole structure contains four pollen sacs or four Microsporangia. Here you can see the enlarged image that is showing the four microsporangia in case of a bilobed anther. And due to the presence of these four microsporangia, we call it as tetrasporangiate or diathecus. If we see the microsporangium, this microsporangium contains a mass of cells, which is a mass of microspore mother cells. These microspore mother cells will ultimately give rise to microspores. So if we are going to concentrate over the topic of microsporogenesis, so we should be familiar with the term that what is a microspore. Microspores are the plant spores that develop into male gametophyte or microgametophyte. Each microgametophyte then produces sperm cells for fertilization purpose. The next term which we should know is microsporogenesis. Microsporogenesis refers to the formation of microspores from microspore mother cells inside the microsporangia. In order to understand the whole procedure or whole method of microsporogenesis, first of all, we have to talk about the development of anther and anther wall. A young anther has a mass of meristematic cells which are covered by a single layered epidermis, and then it becomes four lobed, and each lobe forms a microsporangium with microspores, which we already have discussed. Now, how this whole development takes place? This development occurs in the following steps. The first step is when a mass of hypodermal cells become large sized and radially elongated. These cells are known as archisporial cells. Here we have a diagram where you can see the presence of location of these archisporial cells, and we have talked about these cells, that these are the cells of hypodermis which are formed by the elongation and divisions of the cells. These archisporial cells divide by periclinal divisions, and they form two layers of cells or two regions of cells. The outer one region is the primary parietal layer. You can observe this portion. This is primary parietal layer. The inner region or inner layer is of primary sporogenous tissue. We can abbreviate these layers as PPL and PSL. Division of the cells of these layers will ultimately give rise to some other layers, which will be included in the anther wall. Here you can see these are the layers of the anther wall, which are formed by the division of the outer primary parietal layer. Primary parietal layer divide to form multi-layered anther wall, and the layers of the anther wall consist of an outer epidermis, and inner to the epidermis is the endothecium, which also has a thin area called stomium, that is for the dehiscence. Inner to the endothecium is a middle layer that is also further composed of 2 to 3 layers. And the innermost layer is tapetum, which is very important as it provides nourishment to the developing pollen. Here we have a transverse section of microsporangium. Here you can clearly observe that a bilobed anther has 4 microsporangia or pollen sacs. It is also clear from this image that how many walls of the anther are present here. You can see that this is the epidermis, and inner to the epidermis is the layer which is endothecium, and inner to the endothecium is a middle layer which is made up of further 2 to 3 layers. And the innermost layer is known as tapetum. Here you can observe this tapetum also. Now the inner region, inner to the tapetum, here we have a mass of sporogenous tissue which give rise to microspore mother cells. And those microspore mother cells give rise to microspore. That means this is the region where microspores will be formed. The inner layer, that is primary sporogenous layer, its cells also divide and form a mass of diploid sporogenous tissue, as we have already talked about it, which ultimately form microspore mother cells or pollen mother cells. And these pollen mother cells by the division will give rise to microspores. These pollen mother cells divide by meiosis to form haploid microspores or pollen. They are arranged as tetrads, and the cells of tetrad completely separate from each other ultimately develop into mature microspores, and these microspores then will germinate to produce microgametophyte. Here we have a diagram, an image that is showing the whole process of microsporogenesis. The process will start with the pollen mother cell, and you can see here that pollen mother cell contains a diploid nucleus, and after meiosis 1 it gives rise to 2 nuclei, and after meiosis 2 it gives rise to 4 haploid nuclei. These 4 haploid nuclei, they ultimately form 4 microspores. And these microspores here are arranged in the form of a special structure which is known as tetrad. After separation from the tetrad, these microspores release and they ultimately mature to form pollen grains. So this is the whole process showing that how a pollen mother cell give rise to 4 microspores and ultimately 4 pollen grain. Here we have another diagram that is showing this same procedure, starting from microspore mother cell, and then it ultimately give rise to a tetrad of microspores after meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Then separation of the tetrad takes place, resulting in the release of microspores and their conversion to mature pollen grains. So if we are talking about microsporogenesis, we have seen that the process is based upon cell division. in cytokinesis. So in this case, in fact, in case of microsporogenesis, timing of cytokinesis is very important. And it varies. And on the basis of the timing of cytokinesis, we can divide microsporogenesis into two types. The first type is successive microsporogenesis. In case of successive microsporogenesis, what happens? Cytokinesis occurs in this case after meiosis 1, and it results in two cells, and four cells will be formed after meiosis 2. This type of microsporogenesis will be successive microsporogenesis. But if cytokinesis does not occur until after meiosis 1 and cell formation results only after meiosis 2, then this type of microsporogenesis will be simultaneous microsporogenesis. You can understand these two types of microsporogenesis by looking at this image. Here we have a microsporocyte, our microspore mother cell. This microspore mother cell after meiosis 1 give rise to two cells, and ultimately after meiosis 2 it give rise to four cells. This type of microsporogenesis is successive type. The second type is simultaneous microsporogenesis, which is quite different from the successive microsporogenesis because of the difference in timing of cytokinesis. Here you can see that microsporocyte or microspore mother cell, it will give rise to four cells after meiosis 2. So this is simultaneous microsporogenesis. Finally, we have our description about the role of tapetum. As we already have talked about tapetum, that it is the innermost layer of the anther wall, and it is very important because it helps in nourishment to the developing pollen grain. But it has some other roles also, as it has role in formation of pollen wall. Thirdly, the amoeboid type of tapetum produces a special type of enzyme which is known as chelase enzyme. As the name of the enzyme indicates, it is for dissolution of a special material, chelose, which is present in the walls of microspore tetrads. Definitely, chelase enzyme will dissolve chelose walls of tetrads, resulting in the separation of individual microspores are individual pollen grain. It also produces an oily coating over some pollen grain that is helpful in pollination because it is for insect attraction. So this was all about the role of the tapetum, as well as we have talked about the whole procedure of the microsporogenesis. Now here we have references, and this was all about the topic. Thank you so much.